This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part 4 of radian measure of angles. And in this video, we do one conversion. We convert 1 radian to degrees. We want to find out what 1 radian is if it's converted to degrees. And then, starting in part 5, we do a lot of different conversions, going from degree measures to radians, or from radian measure to degree measures. What is the degree measure of 1 radian? That's the same thing as somebody saying 1 radian equals how many degrees. And remember, we don't have to write radian, we could just say 1 equals. All right, so now we have to remember how we define radians. So we have to have some angle here, and the radian measure is the length of the arc divided by the radius. So in order for the length of the arc, wherever it is, I'm not sure where S is going to be, it's somewhere up here, so that when I divide S over R to get 1, what is that going to tell me? If S over R is equal to 1, that means that S has to be the same length as R. So what we want is to make about the same length here as R. Okay, so in other words, this is actually the number R. So you can look at it and guess, well, gosh, what does it look like? It looks like it's less than 90 degrees. It looks like maybe it's more than 45 degrees, etc. So let's see what it is exactly. So we're going to use the idea that pi is the same thing as 180 degrees. So I'm starting off now with the number 1, okay? And I want to get the answer in degrees. So I want to multiply it by something so I get degrees in the numerator. So I could either multiply by 180 degrees over pi or pi over 180 degrees, because since those are the same number, when you divide one by the other, it's like multiplying by 1. So if I multiply by 180 degrees over pi, I am now going to have my answer in degrees. So what's that mean? That means that 1 radian here is exactly 180 degrees over pi. Or, how do I write it like this even better? It's 180 over pi degrees. So this is the exact answer right here. Now let's go ahead and round that. So now pi is not 3.14. You actually want to use a calculator where you plug in the number pi exactly. So in your calculator you want to put 180 degrees and then divide by pi. All right, so I get in my calculator 57.295779 approximately. So depends how far you want to round it. So let's say rounded to the nearest tenth of a degree, it would be 57.3 degrees. So when you look at this picture here, this angle is approximately 57 degrees. That's approximate. So 1 radian is about 57.3 degrees. So note, this is the important part, note 1 degree is much smaller than 1 radian. So it's very important, if you want to write your answer in degrees, you need to use that degree symbol. If you just write the number 1, or you write 1 radian, it means it's not in degrees.
This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.